So you're an Amazon seller and you want to get more sales on Amazon. Yeah, me too. That's why in this video, I'm going to show you four step-by-step ways of getting more sales starting today on Amazon. And yes, there are some paid ways to get more sales on Amazon, but there are a ton of free ways as well. I'm going to cover everything here in this video. Just a couple quick things. So number one, this video is going to be a little bit more of an overview, kind of going a mile wide and an inch deep, using that analogy. But in the description section of this video, and maybe even the comment section as well, I'll have links to everything that I reference. So if there's anything particular here that really speaks to you in how you can improve your ultimate Amazon sales, you can go and check out those resources right there. And then number two, I'm gonna kind of do everything step-by-step in chronological order. So I'm gonna timestamp kind of the four steps to generating more sales on Amazon. So for some of you, it'll make more sense to kind of maybe skip to number three or to number four, but I would encourage you to watch the entire video and I'll try to be as concise and as valuable as possible. So without further ado, let's go ahead and get to it. So the first thing that you wanna do to improve your Amazon sales, which you may have already done, but for a lot of especially new sellers have not done this, and this is kind of the core and root of all of their marketing and sales problems, is understanding the value proposition of your product. So this isn't even optimizing your listing or anything like that, but really boiling down and really understanding, are you offering something that people actually want? And it's not just a belief that you have, but backed by actual quantitative data. If your answer is, I don't really know, boom, that's the problem. And that's the problem of so many, especially brand new Amazon sellers and just new business owners in general. If you have a product that looks and feels like everyone else, it's like having a resume and you're trying to get a job at a company, but your resume is identical to everybody else. You're not getting the job. And the same thing with Amazon, you're not gonna get the sale. You could still get some sales, but do not expect it. What you need to do is understand better than any other human being on the face of the planet, your audience. What are their needs? What are their wants? What are their desires? What do they look at with existing products and like about them? And what do they dislike? And one really, really great tool to help you with this is the free review downloader tool by Helium 10. So they have this Chrome extension, and within the Chrome extension, they have a free review downloader tool to where you can actually analyze and extract the most commonly and frequently used phrases in the review, kind of the total review data of your top competitors on Amazon or the top sellers in your category, and clearly see, okay, these are, you know, X, Y, and Z are extremely important to my customers. And if you're not delivering on that, well, that could be the issue right there. So really understanding your value proposition that might be out of alignment, and you can maybe even do a better job of aligning yourself within your customers' needs and wants. But that's the first biggest issue. If you really are, you know, analyzing yourself and saying, well, Sumner, I have a product that looks like everyone else's. It just has a different logo. My images are kind of nice. My copy is kind of nice, but it's pretty much the same thing. That could be the issue. And you really, your business decision's up to you. But in my case, maybe I would kind of liquidate that initial inventory. And with my new inventory, I'd find a way to really differentiate. Maybe I'd find ways of, you know, including value with some kind of ebook. Maybe I would, you know, improve upon the quality or some of the design features or whatever it may be, of course, depending on the product. But again, analyze your value proposition, understand your audience better than anyone else, and basically look at what do they need and want, and then deliver that to them in a way that nobody else is. It's really that kind of simple, a little bit harder to put into practice, but very, very, very important, which ties into everything else we're about to discuss. But I think I touched on that enough. If you have questions about that or anything else, let me know in the comments and I'll have resources about this specifically in the description below. The second way to increase your sales on Amazon is to optimize your listing. Now, you may already think, oh, Summer, I'm good on that. Let's move to number three because I already have, you know, well-optimized images, you know, great keyword optimization, great copywriting and all of that. So I'm good to go. Let's go to number three. No, I can guarantee you, if you are watching this right now, that your listing is missing out on sales that it could be making right now, period, end of story. Okay. Now there's a difference between striving for perfection and constantly working and working to get something perfect, which will never ultimately happen. And just simple tweaks and simple things that you can do to your listing that'll ultimately right now, starting today, improve your conversion optimization and ultimately start generating more sales with the traffic that you're already getting. Or maybe if you've been really struggling with sales, this is something that could kind of break the wall or break the barrier and at least see some kind of measurable impact. Again, depending on how you implement this and your product and all of that, because I know there's so many different people watching this. But I have an entire 1 hour, literally step-by-step Amazon listing optimization video. There's a ton of free stuff in there specifically about how to improve your listing. And that goes from number one, what keyword research tools are you using and how big is your master keyword list? A lot of sellers that I find have very, very few, you know, they're kind of master keyword lists or the keywords that they use to optimize their listing. Either number one, they're using a tool that's not very good, or it's not really designed for the Amazon search engine specifically. And then number two, they have a very short list of maybe a few hundred keywords. By the way, a few hundred keywords is a very short master keyword list. I like to have at least 1,000 to 2,000 keywords in my master keyword list. This is basically trying to identify all of the relevant keywords that customers are searching into Amazon to and Google to find my product, and then making sure that kind of the top search most relevant keywords are in my title, my subject matter, search terms, bullet points, and description. So if your search, if your subject matter field isn't filled out, there's an opportunity right there. If you my two favorite tools for keyword optimization are Seller Tools and Helium 10 in terms of accuracy, efficiency, and speed. So if you did, there's other great tools out there as well, so don't get me wrong, but there's a lot of other really crappy tools out there. So the tool that you use, the way that you use the tool, how big your master keyword list was, how well you're optimizing your listing from a keyword standpoint. One big one is, again, if you go to your Amazon Seller Central account, look at your backend keywords kind of in the search term area, and you'll see a subject matter field. If that's not filled out, there's an opportunity right there. Make sure that if you have A-plus content, that all of the alternative text for all of your images have some of your main keywords or some of your keywords from your master list there in the alt text. And again, a lot more, again, video will be below, kind of going in more depth about keyword optimization. Number two is images. I find so many Amazon sellers fail completely and miserably with their Amazon product photography. It is kind of a little bit difficult to kind of master or really hit on, but essentially a few things that I see that's common is, number one, each image should have a very specific purpose. And I see a lot of sellers that kind of have a couple images that pretty much tell the same story or say the same thing. Like, they may highlight the same you know, it might be like just two different angles of the product. It's like, okay, well, what does this angle do that one didn't? Basically, if you think about someone going to your Amazon listing, clicking on your images, each one should have a completely different kind of point that it's highlighting. And what's really great is, and something that I like to do to kind of keep things simple is, with the bullet points that I have, right? My bullet points should highlight the five most important aspects about my product, the five most important benefits and features that my product offers, kind of my value proposition. And I want to make sure that I have at least, you know, five images that line up almost perfectly with those bullet points. Okay, so it could be, you know, super easy to assemble, just making that up, but super easy to assemble. Okay, great, I wanna make sure I have an image highlighting that my product is super easy to assemble. So kind of, number one, again, going back to step one, you need to understand your audience. Again, using the free Helium 10 review downloader tool it's one of my favorite tools. By the way, I'm not alone in this. Tim Ferriss, he doesn't use this tool specifically, but he hires a VA to analyze review data, and this is how he's literally made millions of dollars in cookbooks, is by analyzing data from reviews and really simply looking at the most common phrases that of benefits and pain points that existing customers have about existing product options or your competitors' products, and you figure out, okay, this is what is important to them, so let me make sure that my product offers that, and then I call that out specifically in my bullet points, in my description, and in my images. Okay, so that's step one, is really understanding your audience, and that's a really simple and free tool that can help you do that really quickly, and that can help you, you know, quickly optimize and better improve your listing to where when someone goes to your listing, it's like, oh my gosh, you know, I had this pain point or I had this hesitation, and you just kind of hammered down and nailed every single one down in a way that no other listing did. So that's specifically about the images. Also, you want to have a mix of product images, lifestyle images, and infographics. So product image, just very nice, crisp, clean images of your product with a white background. Lifestyle images are your target audience using and enjoying your product, you know, in some kind of photo. And as a little tip, you can give your product out for free to certain influencers and get images in return. So this could be a super inexpensive way and get some really high quality, real images of, you know, influencers using your product. Just a little tip for getting lifestyle images, really, really easy to get. And they're some of the highest converting in a lot of different ways, and definitely on your Amazon listing. And then number three is infographics. So if you don't have infographics or any of these that I'm saying, write this down and maybe consider including this in your Amazon listing. But with infographics, essentially it can be like a lifestyle image or a product image with some text and maybe a couple graphics that highlight a specific benefit or feature of your product that maybe wouldn't be so apparent. Okay, so you can kind of call out and show. Another example would be a comparison table. This is another form of an infographic where it's basically your product compared to your top two or top three competitors, and kind of like a checkbox saying, you know, we do X, Y, and Z, and our competitors do not do X, Y, and Z. And that's another really powerful high converting image specifically. Images are so important. Your customers can't hear, they can't taste, they can't smell your product. All they can do is see it. So the visual aspect is hugely critical. And I find almost even bigger brands that I've worked with completely missing the mark on this, in my opinion. And we've seen measurable results from clients that I've worked with my own listings, of course. So just something to kind of keep note, very, very important. That's why I spent so much time on it. Images, your keyword optimization, and lastly about images, actually, it's not really images. Recently, Amazon rolled out that non-brand registered sellers, or at least some, and this is still in beta, are able to actually upload videos to your listing now. So even if you're not, if you are brand registered, you should absolutely have a video for your listing. Of course, not maybe as easy to get as images, but definitely something I think worth investing in. And then if you are a even non-brand registered, and for the longest time you thought, oh, well, I can't have a video in my listing, now you can. You can actually have, potentially have a video as part of your main images and part of your listing. Very, very powerful. Can ultimately increase conversion. So that's just another little tip about images. And then, like I said, lastly is your listing copy. Another huge area of improvement. I find the vast majority, 99.9% of sellers, doing maybe either a terrible job to an okay job. But basically, the question that you wanna ask, or there's a few questions asked, but one really, really important that I see a lot of sellers missing is, if you, be honest with yourself, if you were to give me your listing bullet points and I was to take a look at them, would I be jumping up and down, thrilled and unbelievably excited to buy your product? Or would I be like, oh, that's nice, right? Your bullet points should get someone emotionally triggered and emotionally excited. They should be filled with personality to where no other bullet points and description look like yours, that no other listing copy even comes close to yours. That should be the mindset. And when you kind of position it in that mindset, then you're like, okay, well maybe I could, there's some effort that I can put in to kind of improve these. And really a lot of times it's not really as much, first of all, it's free to do, to kind of change the copy. You can do this yourself. An employee or VA can do this, depending on, you know, your task allocation. But relatively easy to do, and it's free to do, okay? It just takes a little bit of creativity and being clever. An example is, you know, I was working on a client's listing, and one of the specific kind of call outs is, hey, our product's easy to assemble. So what they had before, one of their bullet points said easy assembly or easy to assemble. Boring. Does that get me excited jumping up and down on my seat? No, not really. But instead, what we kind of changed that section to be very specific, is something like, I forget the exact words, but unlike other products that require a master's in engineering to set up, our product comes with simple instructions, you know, easy to assemble parts, blah, 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 right? But just that little kind of snippet of, you know, that we don't require an engineering degree, right? Obviously it's hyperbole, it's exaggerated, but no other listing is doing that. No other, and hardly any brands are doing that. That brings so much personality to your listing. Have fun with it. I personally am in the mindset of going a little bit overboard than underboard. And in all ways, in all these kind of little ways with your bullet points, your images, even keyword optimization, you want to crush and dominate your competition. And like I said, it's really not that hard. It just takes some creativity and being clever. And I'm in the mindset of kind of breaking the mold and going a little bit overboard than underboard and standing out, to where your Amazon customers are going through multiple listings. They come to yours, and in all these different ways, you're just connecting with them in a way nobody else is. Do you honestly think they're gonna choose you over them? Yes, probably, or at least increase the number of customers who choose your product and your offering over others, okay? So I get really passionate about it because I see literally like 99% of sellers can have huge improvements to their listing. And these are some of the more specific ways. Again, resources about this in more detail in the description section below. Hope you're taking notes, and we have two more. The third way to get more sales on Amazon is Amazon PPC advertising. In my opinion, every single private label seller on Amazon should absolutely be utilizing Amazon advertising, and there's so many reasons why. And by the way, when I say that, that does not mean that you need to spend a ton of money every month and a ton of time managing campaigns. There's some actually really simple ways you can use Amazon PPC. It's a very powerful tool, but there's a few reasons. So number one is, you're selling on Amazon, your customers are on Amazon. If you're not advertising and actively sponsoring your listing to expand your reach, you are 100% missing out on sales right now. So number one, if you're not using Amazon advertising, you're missing out on sales. Number two, Amazon PPC, compared to some other kind of advertising models or advertising platforms, is relatively easy to do because the people who are on Amazon are there to buy. For example, people on Facebook are not on Facebook to buy. So there's a little bit more kind of strategy and kind of more of a funnel that's needed. Where with Amazon, people are already there to buy. You can target very specific keywords that people are typing in onto Amazon, and get your listing to show up right in front of them as they're typing in these keywords or looking for very, very specific products that are relevant to yours. Get in front of them and ultimately make more sales, and do so extremely profitably. Again, it's a tool that can be used in multiple ways. You can use it to increase market share. You can use it to, you know, kick competitors off of your listing in certain ways, and I can go down a whole rabbit hole with this. There's a lot of uses for it, but if you're not using it at all, number one, you should be. Number two, most Amazon sellers, again, the vast majority of Amazon sellers that I see using it, are only tapping into a very small potential of Amazon PPC advertising. I could make several videos about this, and actually do. I have a whole core affordable course on Udemy and Skillshare about it. I'll try to be making more free content, of course, here on YouTube as well, and we'll have links to those in the description below. But just a few tips about Amazon PPC that you can kind of, some campaigns that you can set up for your products right now that can at least generate a few additional highly, highly profitable sales every single month or the following. So number one is take your main keywords, okay, and put them into what's called a misspelling generator. So just Google misspelling generator. It'll give you, you know, this free tool. You plug in a keyword, and basically this tool will generate a huge list of commonly misspelled phrases that are related to your main keyword. So do that, generate a list of like 1,000 misspelled keywords, create an exact match campaign, target those at like a 2-cent bid, and then guess what? Anytime someone mistypes your main keywords, you're eligible then, your listing is eligible to show up and get in front of those customers, and yeah, it may not generate a ton of sales, but like, and I'm gonna go through a few more examples, but when you aggregate all these together and the law of averages, you may be surprised and generate several highly profitable sales every month, and that's just one quick, easy, very profitable way of generating more sales on Amazon. So that's a misspellings campaign. Number two, kind of similar, is take your main keywords and translate them into Spanish if you're in the United States. Maybe you'd be French if you're in Canada, and I don't know what languages, maybe in the UK or Germany, but just kind of look at the biggest minority in your country, the biggest minority kind of language, and then take your main keywords, translate them into that language, and again, target those, create an exact match campaign, target those at like a lower bid, you know, anywhere 2 cents to 25 cents, it depends on the product and your strategy and all of that, but at a lower bid, and again, when people type in those specific keywords in that language, then you, all your competitors aren't thinking or doing this, your listing can then show up and ultimately get that sale very profitably. So that's foreign kind of language campaign. Number three is creating a product targeting campaign. And with this specific product targeting campaign, you can use a tool like Helium 10 Black Box. Again, I love Helium 10. For those of you who follow, you already know this. And they have a free trial with this. I'm not trying to push the tool. And you can also do this manually, but essentially you can use this the Helium 10 Black Box tool and easily find all products that are on Amazon that have, you know, X, Y, and Z keywords in their title that also have, that are not Prime eligible, number one. Number two, have between 0 and 1 reviews. Number three, they have less than a 3-star rating. Number four, they only have, you know, three or less images that they're utilizing, you know, 3 or less images in their listing. And then number five is, you know, basically similar products that have a super high price point. So what all of these different product types have in common, you can, again, like I said, use a tool like Blackbox to do this manually and create this giant list of these ASINs or these products that you can target with Amazon PPC advertising, is these are very low competitive ASINs. And even with your listing right now, there's a good likelihood that you can beat, kind of quote unquote, beat these listings. So when someone lands on their listing and scrolls down and they see your ad there in the product detail page, have a very high likelihood of clicking. And since these are likely less competitive ASINs to target, can do so very profitably for like low cost per click and all of that. Okay, so again, not guaranteed, but in my opinion, definitely worth testing. I run this with all my products and all my clients' products, and it's highly, highly profitable. And depending on the product, can be, you know, really be surprising in terms of the number of sales it generates. So that's kind of some of those less competitive, relatively easy campaigns that you can set up right now and start making more sales starting today. May take some time before you start seeing them come in. They may not be giant sales drivers, but there's definitely sales out there that you could be making that you're currently missing. And then number two is another thing I see a lot of sellers missing out on is not having enough campaigns or enough targets, okay? If you wanna get more sales with Amazon PPC advertising and ultimately, you know, direct sales from advertising as well as helping you to increase organic rank and then generating more sales from that organic rank, you need to make sure that you're kind of utilizing Amazon PPC to its fullest potential. Even if you're not brand registered, what you can do and what I would make sure that you do, this is what I do, is I make sure I have an exact manual campaign, a phrase manual campaign, a broad manual campaign, an auto campaign, and a product targeting campaign for some of my kind of, you know, either complementary products and for similar products, kind of my top competitor products. So kind of all those 5 campaigns, I think that was 5, at least. I have significantly more than those 5. I also have the other campaigns that I mentioned and a lot more because I'm constantly testing. But if I just said this to you and you don't have all 5 of those campaigns set up, boom, there's another opportunity for you right there to make more sales on Amazon. Again, I could go down a whole rabbit hole. I'll include links with more information about Amazon PPC, but hopefully that's helpful. And that is number three. Like I said, I think everyone, Amazon sellers should be utilizing Amazon PPC at least to some extent. And finally, the fourth way to generate more sales on Amazon specifically is by driving external traffic. So now at this point, you've evaluated your value proposition and you do have a product or an offering that is extremely valuable and does something or delivers value in a way that no other competitor does. Your listing is top-notch, images, copywriting, keyword optimization, you're maxing out and utilizing Amazon PPC to its fullest extent within your business goals. And then now number four is driving external traffic, so traffic that's not on Amazon and people that aren't on Amazon, and getting them to Amazon, specifically to your Amazon listing. And thankfully there are a ton of ways, but I'll try to cover some of the most powerful, some of the highest ROI ways that I have found and share that with you. Again, I have full videos. I have a full actually product launch playlist here on YouTube that covers a lot of these that I'm about to cover. It's specifically about product launch, but it even goes into after product launch as well. Number one is Pinterest and Google advertising. What's really unique about Pinterest and Google ads, which is different from Facebook and Instagram ads, is that there are people who are on Pinterest and Google that are there specifically to buy. And there are very easy ways of kind of, by targeting very, very specific keywords, or maybe in Pinterest, very specific interests, and targeting these people who are basically looking for your product type. So for example, if you're selling a red spatula, there are people on Pinterest potentially looking for red spatulas, and on Google looking for red spatulas. And by the way, on Google, I believe it's the latest statistic, it's 46% of product purchases begin on the Google platform. So a huge percentage. The majority is Amazon, but there's a huge percentage on Google. People are on Google and Pinterest, they're looking for your product. You can basically create an ad, target that ad to very specific keywords that people are typing in, what are known as purchase intent keywords, like red spatula or you know, kitchen spatula, things like that. You know, target those keywords, someone types them in, sees your ad, clicks on your ad, and then your ad can go directly to your Amazon listing and ultimately generate more sales and help you increase rank and ultimately reviews as well that way. So that's just kind of one method. Again, I have full step-by-step videos on this specifically for Amazon. Number two is micro-influencers. Something that you can do is you can either, you know, have paid partnerships with influencers, or you can target, you know, Instagram, TikTok, Pinterest, and YouTube influencers that have between, you know, 2,000 to 9,000 followers or even more, and specifically give your product away for free in return for a shout out, or you can give your product away for free for lifestyle images. You can use it. You can use this kind of method in a lot of different ways, but basically give your product for free and then in return get a shout out. And just for perspective, this is one of the better results that we've received, but we reached out to an Instagram influencer who had almost 1 million followers. We gave this influencer our product for free in return for a shout out. And the influencer gave us a shout out on their Instagram story specifically. And we saw our Amazon sales skyrocket. I think it was a 100, I'm trying to remember the exact statistic, over a 48 hour period of that kind of story going live, there is a 148% increase in our sales on Amazon. It was crazy. And again, that was kind of probably the best results that we've got from this, but it can be very powerful. It's almost free to do, you know, it's the basically the cost of your product is what you're giving away in return for a shout out, but really can be very high ROI, really, really effective and powerful advertising. Again, full video about that as well. So that's Google search ads specifically, Pinterest ads. Also, by the way, creating content on Pinterest, really, really powerful. Number four, you know, micro influencers. Number five is just creating content on social media in general and just having at least somewhat of a presence. What I like to do is have at least 10, you know, pieces of content on all major social media platforms. So that includes, you know, for me, 10 pieces, at least 10 pieces of content on Instagram, 10 pins on Pinterest, 10 posts on Facebook, 10 videos on TikTok. That's even maybe, I respond to 10 questions on Quora for my brand. That's getting a little bit into kind of some more detail, but I want to 10, you know, interactions on Reddit. I'm still kind of getting into the Reddit scene. So, but in general, just at least 10 pieces of content, kind of that double digit mark on all major social media platforms, maybe at least one video on YouTube, for example, to at least have some presence, have those keywords there, have the hashtags there. And that alone, you know, you do it once and that can have recurring kind of results later on. And I'm a big advocate of continuing to kind of create content on a weekly and monthly basis. So my wife and I are running hard for all of our private label brands. We're running, you know, content all literally like every single day, but at least have somewhat of a presence. I definitely recommend, really not that difficult to do, and can have, you know, you can be surprised by some of this content even going viral potentially, or at least having that kind of evergreen traffic back to your Amazon listing. And there's a lot more ways as well. And I'll be creating more videos as well, like growing and nurturing an email list and basically growing this email list on launch day and then sending traffic to your Amazon listing and all these other ways. And I'll be having kind of step-by-step videos and case study videos of me actually implementing this with my own brands. And I'm gonna give you my exact, you know, cost, my exact strategy, profit that I generated, the timeline, everything. And specifically, I'm gonna be making these videos regarding these kind of case studies over the next 2 months. So if you wanna kind of catch those and other hopefully valuable videos as well, be sure to subscribe to the channel. And that kind of concludes today's video, which I know went a little bit longer than expected, but I hope you liked it. And if you did, be sure to give the video a thumbs up and check out the other playlists and content that is in the description section of this video. And if you had any questions about this video or anything that you'd like to add that maybe I missed that could help other Amazon sellers, please feel free to let us know in the comments below. I want to make sure that every video here helps the Amazon community as much as possible. So I'd really appreciate your help in that. And if there's any way that I can help you with any questions you had, let me know in the comments. And be sure to join our AMZ Escape Plan Facebook group. That's a great place for Q&A. I have a lot of other great and free content in the files section of that group. So join the group, go to the files section, a lot of free content there, along with a lot of other great stuff coming very, very soon, which I'm really excited about. And I really appreciate, as always, you watching for all of your support. Thank you so much. Hope you found the video valuable, and I look forward to seeing you in future videos.